Hello, I'm Mito. This may seem like an odd thing to say right from the beginning, but did you know that the human body and its systems operate a lot like your cell phone? Let's think about it. Your phone has a lot of apps running in the background that typically work smoothly so long as your battery has enough power. Of course, these apps won't work at all if your phone isn't charged each day. Whoops, we forgot to plug in our phone last night before falling asleep, and now we need to get on with our day. I guess we'll have to choose which apps are most important to use today. We for sure have to be able to call and text a few people. There's some emails we need to send out too. Doesn't look like we'll have enough battery to get to scroll on social media or watch videos during our lunch break. Oh well, we'll charge our phone tonight. I can go one day without all that. Remember how I said that your phone operates a lot like your body? Well, your body requires a lot of apps to be open each day in order to function properly, like seeing, hearing, eating, breathing, walking, pumping blood, thinking, and the list goes on. These are just a few basic apps that are constantly running each day. All these systems require energy, just like the apps on your phone require battery power to function properly. So how do we power all of this? Typically sleep, water, food, oxygen, and even some medications help to recharge our batteries each day. We get up the next morning refreshed and ready to handle all the things our body needs to do without even thinking about it. Sure, some days you may wake up feeling unrefreshed and need to postpone more energy-draining tasks to another day, but it's not like you have to do that every day. Here's the thing. There is a huge population of people whose bodies do not fully recharge each night. Many never gain a full battery ever again. Myalgic encephalomyelitis, chronic fatigue syndrome, or ME-CFS, often referred to as ME, is a chronic and disabling illness that affects many body systems like the nervous system, immune system, and others. I won't go into the full science behind it, but to give you an idea, people with ME experience a range of debilitating symptoms that make everyday activities incredibly difficult, or sometimes impossible. Things that most of us take for granted, like showering, sitting upright, or even having a conversation, can drain their energy completely. Their battery cannot hold a charge like it once did, so they have to plug in often throughout the day to bring their battery charge back up. In short, an ME-CFS battery has limited energy reserves, drains quickly, and can take double, triple, even quadruple the amount of time to recharge, and they may only be able to run critical apps on some days. How then can they get anything done? They must turn off unnecessary apps that are draining their battery. So if they want to have a conversation with someone, they may need to lie down, turn off or dim the lights, close their eyes, find a quieter place, take rest breaks during the conversation, and even elevate their legs. Things like this can sometimes save at least a little of their battery. There are patients whose battery levels are so low that they are confined to their home, or worse, their beds, invisibly battling alone each day, requiring so few apps to be open that they are simply surviving. There is now more and more research helping us understand why this happens. While we don't know exactly how many people have ME-CFS, or now post-COVID ME-CFS, we do know that millions of people worldwide suffer with it. The reality is, this may be the most common disease you have never heard of. How can you help? It's pretty simple. Believe them. Understand that they did not ask for this. They are not faking it. They do not want to live their lives in a confined and modified way. If you have a functioning battery, take action and help others to understand and learn about this disease. Help offload tasks that hardly drain your battery, but would crash someone with ME, so they can attend their child's birthday party, join you for dinner, or simply hold a conversation. Like and share this video. Be a part of the movement to educate so all individuals impacted by ME/CFS and post-COVID ME/CFS can receive the care they deserve.